Greetings, Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath. Thanks for checking out my video. I've got a few questions to go through here today. And the first one is, I've got chronic fatigue. I'm always fatigued. Why am I always fatigued? What are the reasons behind being fatigued? There are many reasons behind chronic fatigue. Some people call it yuppie flu. Some people call it ME. Some people call it, you know, it's known by many different names over the past 20, 30, 40 years. But I'm noticing with the new millennials, with the new young people, we're getting another whole generation of chronic fatigue syndrome sufferers through. In my opinion, it's a result of a poor lifestyle and a breakdown of the person's hormonal health and immune health over a period of many, many years. I've seen so many people with chronic fatigue syndrome in my clinic, and in most cases I can tell you, I see the background of that person had some kind of stress. Stressful job, stressful relationship. They stayed up too late, too long. They paid lip service to a good, healthy lifestyle. I see it in teenagers a lot today. Just like I did back in the 80s. I mean, I'm still seeing the same patterns today. But I'm seeing a lot more today and more severe cases. And I think it's because of the internet and Google and social media and people's inability to switch off and go to bed on time. So I see chronic sleep patterns often underpin chronic fatigue. Note the word chronic, okay, not acute, chronic. So this is a pattern of dysfunction going on with a person for several years prior to when their health finally broke down. And doctors are often at a loss on how to treat chronic fatigue syndrome. And many patients often are at a loss to resolve chronic fatigue. So here are some of the things that you can do, you know, to find out really what's underpinning the problem. I wrote about this in Candida Crusher in my book. A good thing for you to do is keep an eye on your blood tests over a prolonged period of time, particularly from the past, you know, and right going in now and as well into the future. Look for signs of low-grade inflammation. For example, elevated C-reactive protein, low vitamin B12, low vitamin D, problems with white blood cell counts, like, you know, a slightly lowered white blood cell count. There is another marker called eosinophil that can be often a little bit elevated. So there'll be some kind of a pattern in the blood that's been going on often for several years, on and off, sometimes normal, sometimes low, sometimes a little bit higher. So keep an eye on for a dysfunctional pattern. That will show you that there's a background of immune dysfunction. The other thing that you want to be aware of is cortisol. So your adrenal response. So keep an eye on what the adrenals are doing in the background. Many times they are running, you know, on borrowed time, really, because you're pushing the lifestyle too hard. The adrenals get quite tired. Cortisol could either be elevated sometimes of the day or depressed. A salivary cortisol is a very clever thing to do with a chronic fatigue pattern like this. Thyroid stimulating hormone may also be a little bit on the high side, indicating a bit of hypothyroidism. You may find also TSH to be a bit on the low side, indicating more of a hyper nature, and often find a disparity between cortisol and thyroid stimulating hormone. There could be some issues there going on. That will tell me that your lifestyle has been out of balance for some time. So look at these low-grade patterns of dysfunction that are going on. Sleep and energy work together. Many people with chronic fatigue have got very poor sleep patterns. They'll also have very poor gut function. Many people with CFS, chronic fatigue syndrome, will have bloating, gas, they'll have, you know, constipation or diarrhea, they'll have food allergies, they'll have ear, nose or throat dysfunctions. Very common to have a low-grade throat problem or a low-grade sinus infection. So all these, again, indications of a dragging immune system that needs pushing up. A stool test is a very clever thing for you to do if you've got CFS and you're watching this now. You want to know what your gut is doing. Particularly, you want to know what the beneficial bacteria are doing. And most probably, you'll have low levels of lactobacillus, bifidobacteria, enterococcus, and E. coli, or bacteroides. So these are five classes of beneficials that should all be around 2 or 3+ on a stool culture. I can tell you after looking at stool reports of probably well over 1,000 people with chronic fatigue syndrome that most people have got low levels of these particular beneficial bacteria. Many also will have elevated levels of dysbiotic bacteria like Pseudomonas, Citrobacter. Many also will have candida, that you can actually culture to 1, 2, or 3 plus in the stool. And many also will show low-grade inflammation in the gut with other markers that we find in a stool test. These are very important things for you to keep in mind and to consider if you want to, you know, work out reasons why you're not recovering from chronic fatigue. The gut needs improving. The hormone system needs improving. The diet needs improving. But the diet is not first and foremost in chronic fatigue syndrome. Okay? I believe the lifestyle is number one. You must get the correct lifestyle happening if you're going to try and recover from a chronic fatigue pattern. There's no point liking people on Facebook or putting pictures of your puppy dog on Instagram at 3 a.m. Because you know you've got chronic fatigue syndrome and you can't sleep at that time of day. You've got to get your lifestyle patterns back on check. You've got to start getting to bed earlier. You've got to start switching computers and cell phones off. You can't walk around the whole day with a mobile phone up to your face if you're trying to recover from chronic fatigue syndrome. So if you're a millennial watching this now, please pay attention. It's important for you to get good sleep patterns if you want to try and improve your energy patterns. It's important for you to assess some of the low-grade dysfunctional patterns in the body and try and correct those, along with tweaking the diet a bit and improving the lifestyle, and this can slowly pull you out of a fatigue pattern. Some patients need intravenous therapies, particularly intravenous vitamin C may help, give them a boost. But chronic fatigue is recoverable. Another final thing I'll leave you with, often there'll be low-grade chronic little infections going on there in the body. They could be around the appendix region. They could be around the ileocecal valve, the connection between the large and small bowel. There could be little infection in the throat. Stool tests will pick up something. Blood tests will reveal it as those markers that I've pointed out. And these infections can often be treated with antifungal, antimicrobials, instead of plunging you back into antibiotics again, which are going to make you even more sick. Check out Candida Remove. I formulated this for really cleaning up the gut and getting rid of many different kinds of pathogens that people like CFS have. All right? Probiotics are also important to put back in the gut, and so are enzymes. Check out Candida Restore for that reason. So Remove and Restore and Rebuild work beautifully in many chronic fatigue syndrome cases. So I hope that gives you a bit of information on some of the reasons underpinning chronic fatigue syndrome. Thanks for catching up with me.